In today's Deconstruct Zone, we will discuss alternative medication. Recently, there's been a whole lot of controversy with fake medicines and doctors being busted by media organizations. First of all, Dr. Death? That sounds less like a fake doctor and more like a Shaktiman villain. But it's a scary story. Selling pseudoscience and fake medicine in the name of science is a serious offense. The media has rightly castigated these organizations for being anti-scientific and anti-reason. However, despite all this outrage, and the most obvious form of quackery and pseudoscience is going on right beneath our noses, and no one in the media is even mentioning it. Yes, I'm talking about homeopathy. Homeopathy might just be the biggest scam in history since the cartoon The Roadrunner Show. Did you know that a roadrunner's top speed is only 20 miles per hour, while coyotes can reach speeds of up to 43 miles per hour? So in reality, the first and only episode of The Roadrunner Show should have gone like this.
Holy shit. I did it. He's under there. I got him. I fucking got him. Jesus, I'm gonna need a shovel.
Yes, your entire childhood was a lie. Let's come back to the topic. If you're a person who's been taking homeopathic medicines, then I'm sorry to say this, but you've been fed a lie. The general impression is that homeopathy is based on some sort of scientific principles. I mean, after all, people wear white lab coats, have scientific-sounding terms and names, right? Wrong. You can put a lipstick on a pig, but it's still a pig. Let me explain the general principles of homeopathy to you to show you exactly how much of a pseudoscience it really is. Homeopathy was invented in 1796 by Samuel Hahnemann, based on his own doctrines and wacky principles. And the doctrine has not changed since then. Yes, the main principles behind homeopathy have not changed in the last 220 years. And a lot of medical advancement has occurred in the time, in case you haven't noticed. In fact, here are some of the things that were commonplace in medical science 200 years ago. 200 years ago, migraines and seizures were treated by trepanation, which is a fancy term for drilling a hole into your skull. Yes, and surprise, surprise, having a gaping hole drilled into your skull, usually without anesthesia, did very little to help people's headaches. Administering electric shock to your genitals was the most common way of curing erectile dysfunction. Yes, they actually did that. I guess they were just thinking if electric shocks can make your hair stand and hold it there for a long time, it must work on other organs too. But perhaps the most ridiculous of them all was urine therapy, where people drank and bathed in piss because they thought it was good for them. Yes, that actually went on for a really long time. Obviously, now medical science knows that urine therapy doesn't cure one damn thing. Not even that jellyfish thing that you thought about before. But on the bright side, if you have a weird fetish and, you know, your girlfriend found your DVDs, you can pass them off as medical instruction videos. So in the past 200 years, we've seen a lot of advancements in medical science, and we must be really thankful for that. The principles of homeopathy, however, remain pretty much the same. Doesn't sound very scientific, does it? Now wait until you actually hear these principles out. Here. The first principle of homeopathy explained by Professor Richard Dawkins.
One of the central tenets handed down by its founder, Samuel Hahnemann, was that like cures like.
Like cures like makes the unfounded assumption that what causes similar symptoms can cure those symptoms.
The first principle of homeopathy is like cures like. And don't mistake this for vaccines, which involve introducing diseases in small doses to get your immune system activated. The like your like in homeopathy is more along the lines of eating your cat's hair in order to help you with cat allergies, or smoking a few puffs of tobacco to get rid of your lung cancer, or reading a Chetan Bhagat book to overcome your stupidity. Well, if you think that's weird, wait till you hear the second rule of homeopathy.
Homeopathy gets even stranger still.
Homeopaths claim that the more you dilute an active ingredient in water, the stronger medicine it becomes.
Yes, the more dilute the medicine is, the more stronger it is. You have no idea what dilution is until you've seen homeopathic medicines. they mix one compound of the active ingredient, which is the like substance, and mix it with 99 parts of water. Now, this solution is called 1C. Now, this can be shaken 10 times to the side, 10 times up and down. They call it succussion. I call it shaking. But what do I know? I'm not a scientist. Then, one drop of the 1C solution is added to another test tube with 99 drops of water. Now, this is 2C. According to homeopaths, the 2C solution is actually 10 times stronger than 1C because it is 10 times more diluted. Sounds crazy, right? But the homeopaths don't stop there. They take one more drop of the 2C solution and then mix it with 9 more drops of water and then shake again. And they keep going on and on and on till 50C. That's right, 50C. Do you even know how dilute that is? I'll tell you how dilute that exactly is. A drop in a bathtub? No, way, way too strong. A drop in a swimming pool? Still nowhere close. A drop in the Ganges? Still way too strong. A drop in the Pacific Ocean? Still nowhere near the levels of dilution needed. The amount of dilution of the average 50C homeopathic medicine is equivalent to mixing a drop of the active ingredient in a body of water as big as a flippin' solar system, where the sun is at the center and the Pluto at the end. Most importantly, there's not even a single molecule of the initial substance after 13C. So what you're drinking is just water. And just to demonstrate how small a molecule is, it is estimated that at least one molecule of water in every glass that you drink has passed through most toilets in the world at some time or the other. So the chances are that, you know, literally a higher concentration of Chris Hemsworth piss is there in your homeopathic medicine than the initial active ingredient. Maybe that's what's curing you. I mean, the guy's Thor after all. Imagine how absurd the kind of treatment actually is. You know, we'll show you how absurd it is. Watch.
He's stabilizing. Now, does anybody know what sort of car hit him?
Blue Form Mondeo, apparently.
Right, get me a bit of Blue Form Mondeo, put it in water, shake it, dilute it, shake it again, dilute it again, do some more shaking, dilute it some more, and then put 3 drops on his tongue. If that doesn't cure him, I don't know what will.
Here's the thing, guys. That bit was not exaggerated for comedic value. That is exactly how homeopathy works. But, you know, there's this big question that I have. Why do people still keep flocking to homeopathy? Clearly, they see it working for them, right? Well, not exactly. This can be explained by the placebo effect. And what's the placebo effect?
In 1996, 56 volunteers took part in a study to test a new painkiller called trivaricaine. On each subject, one index finger was covered in the new painkiller, while the other remained untouched. Then, both were squeezed in painful clamps. The subjects reported that the treated finger hurt less than the untreated one. This shouldn't be surprising, except trivaricaine wasn't actually a painkiller, just a fake concoction with no pain-easing properties at all. What made the students so sure this dummy drug had worked? The answer lies in the placebo effect, an unexplained phenomenon wherein drugs, treatments, and therapies that aren't supposed to have an effect and are often fake, miraculously make people feel better.
Yes, the placebo effect, the reason why we all take a bath in the morning. Look, I know what some of you are thinking right now. Homeopathy has worked for me and I'll carry on using it. You know, besides, science doesn't even know everything yet, and that's true. Science knows that it does not know everything. Otherwise, it would stop. Just because science doesn't know everything doesn't mean you get to fill the gaps with whatever mumbo-jumbo you want. For example, science keeps changing its mind on what good nutrition constitutes as new evidence keep coming in. Scientists still aren't even sure if milk is good for us or not. But that doesn't give you excuse to eat dog turd. I mean, if you tell someone, hey, I don't know what science says, but eating my dog poo works for me, it makes me feel better. People will think you're a moron, and rightly so. Look, I'm not saying that there's nothing wrong with allopathic medicines in the state of medical science. Some pharmaceutical medicines have proven time and again that they cannot be trusted, and they have adversely damaged our health. For example, just recently we learned that lamotrigine helps you get rid of your skin irritation by burning off what's left of your skin. And aclofentyl helps bring relief from chronic pain by killing you. Look, we're not calling for a complete ban on homeopathy. Homeopathy is harmless on its own, But where it causes real harm is when people take it instead of actual medicine. There are homeopathic medicines available in the market at present that help you deal with everything from a common cold to headache to all the way to cancer. There are even homeopathic medicines in the market that claim to protect you in case of a biochemical terrorist attack. I think it's safe to assume that ISIS fighters aren't trembling at the prospect of some sugar and water pills. Look, people must be free to take whatever they want, but don't you think consumers deserve to know what they're taking? And that's not a radical idea. Many countries in the West, including and not restricted to the United States and the UK, have laws stipulating that homeopathic medicines should be sold in the market carrying a disclaimer stating that there is no scientific evidence that the product being bought actually works. So do consumers here in India know what they're taking? Do homeopathic doctors know that the thing is a scam? Or are they fooling consumers? I caught up with some leading homeopathic doctors and patients to find out more about the practice. Here's a special report.
Homeopathy. Over 150 million Indians use it every year to treat a range of afflictions. More people walked into homeopathic clinics for the first time in 2017 than ever before. Many users claim miraculous cures and benefits and say that they have no need for conventional allopathic medicines anymore after they started using homeopathy. So I sat down and talked to people who've used homeopathy to understand their experiences.
So why did you take homeopathic medicines?
I was suffering from cold and cough for the past 2 weeks or so.
So I was suffering from acute bronchitis that time, so I took it for acute bronchitis.
Some patients seem convinced that it works because it helped cure their ailments, while others weren't so convinced.
Did it work for you? Did homeopathic medicines work for you?
I was very young, so basically I went there for sugar balls, that's it. I didn't know what they are putting inside it.
Most people I talked to seem completely unaware of what was in the medicine.
Do you know what the medicine is?
The medicine they are putting? No, not really.
No clue.
Nor did they know what placebo effect means.
Do you know what the placebo effect is?
Not really.
Is it somewhat related to Tyndall effect?
Yeah, are you talking about the effect when there's sunlight on trees and you can see light?
Somewhat related to it.
Okay, actually that's what it is. It tindalizes your mind. Did you know that the medicine that you take is 9 parts of water mixed with...
When we told them the truth of what is in the homeopathic medicine, let's just say their reactions told the whole story.
Are you serious?
Are you kidding me, dude? Really?
So we decided to contact homeopathic doctors so that we can ask them a few questions about the practice. But we were met with the same response over and over again. No doctor wanted to give us an interview.
Hello. Hi, doctor. I'd like to interview you for a political satire show. Would you be interested? No. Oh, out of station. Of course you are.
It was almost as if they had something to hide. Something like, oh, I don't know, passing off sugar pills as water.
Hello. This is Piyush from Vyond. We'd like to interview you for a homeopathic segment. Would you be interested?
Yeah.
Come on, yeah. It's just for 2 minutes and we'd like to ask you a few questions.
Okay.
Damn. We contacted almost 30 prominent homeopathic doctors, but to no avail.
Yes.
Why you? What do you mean, why you? Why not you? I need to speak to a homeopathic doctor. I wouldn't call you if I needed a professional swimmer, would I? Now, because if the picture going by on your website is anything to go by, you wouldn't make it 5 meters in the pool without...
What?
Amidst all the rage, frustration, and downright begging, it didn't seem like it was going to be our day. Just when we were about to give up, our efforts were finally rewarded.
Yes. Alright, perfect, doctor. Perfect. Thank you. I'll see you tomorrow then, doctor. Yes. Alright, thank you. Thank you so much, doctor. We got it. Ugh! I gotta work on my script.
I gotta get some coffee.
So we made our way to Dr. Gagandeep Ahuja's clinic. And he seemed quite enthusiastic to dispel the misconceptions behind homeopathy.
Can you start by explaining how homeopathy works, doctor?
Homeopathy is an art and science basically, and it has been working on the principle called like your like. In Germany it has been said simile was simila curantur. So we cure the disease according to what has been suffering from, but in more diluted form and more in power.
Yes, but how dilute is the medicine exactly? Dr. Matthew Forbes of the University of Toronto tested homeopathic medicines to check the levels of dilution, and the truth will shock you.
Forbes is looking for any trace of the active ingredient. And what's he find?
It's below a level that we can accurately or precisely measure. It's roughly equivalent to 5 billion times less than the amount of aspirin that you would take in a single pellet.
The active ingredient is a 5 billion times less than what you'd find in an aspirin.
That's right. Yeah,
5 billion times less?
That's right.
Why are people moving towards homeopathy and dissing allopathy right now?
Because it's a rapid, gentle. First of all, rapid. Rapid. Why use rapid? Because it acts very fast than allopathic medicine.
Yes, doctor. I understand what rapid means.
When we dilute a particular medicine, or when we put a drop of that medicine and dilute it with water and alcohol, doesn't it seem like the medicine's capabilities have gone?
No, the medicine's capabilities are not gone because the medicine has raised its power to nanoparticles. The nanoparticles which work on the body. We require minimum dosage.
I'm surprised people haven't opened homeopathic pubs already, you know.
Yeah, that's
Hey bartender, could you fix me up a homeopathic cocktail? Really strong.
But our doctor had an explanation for how homeopathy works despite the crazy levels of dilution.
Water retains the memory. H2 has a property to retain the memory. Okay. It has been proved in various sciences and the various articles have been published in that.
So if water has memory, what about other things that come in contact with water?
More common impurities like sewage and toilet water. All of us drink water that is repeatedly passed through different sewers, potties, and then recycled.
Looks like water has a selective memory loss problem.
It could. We cannot say like that. We cannot, because the water is not to say, we cannot say that we have a...
Can you explain what placebo effect means?
Placebo is like, if you ask me what is placebo, placebo is, as people say, placebo effect. What is placebo? Placebo is that then there is no medicine, it is affecting the body. I strongly say that if a medicine is coming into the market, it will not come as such. I prepared the medicine, it is my medicine. It has to go through various double-blind trials, single-blind trials, then only it can come into the market.
Except that's completely incorrect. There have been numerous double-blind tests on homeopathy and it has failed every single one of them. In fact, the James Randi Educational Foundation, run by this man, promised $1 million to anybody who can conclusively prove that homeopathy works. Many homeopaths have taken up the challenge, but the $1 million prize still remains unclaimed.
But a lot of critics say that it's nothing more than the placebo effect.
If animals are acting, why it is showing the animals are affecting the body.
This is a very popular repeated meme among homeopaths. They often say, homeopathy cannot be a placebo because it is used to treat animals as well. There is only one problem, however. Animals can't f***ing talk. Trust me, I tried.
So tell me, does homeopathy work for you? I think he's saying it's just a placebo. So, would you say that homeopathic doctors are multi-specialists?
Our pathy is based on holistic science. We treat from mind to body to soul.
Will I be able to play my guitar if I take homeopathic medicines?
Yes.
Really?
Yeah.
Because I never used to play it before.
Yes, you can.
No, even if I didn't know how to play it.
Yes. The thing is that it's the mental will, you can do it.
Yes.
ठीक है ना, इफ यू हैव अ विल टू डू इट यू कैन प्ले इट. यू आर बॉर्न विद नथिंग क्वालिटीज.
यस
ठीक है, इट्स द क्वालिटीज व्हिच यू ब्रॉट इट बाय योर मदर एंड फादर एंड द एनवायरनमेंट.
यस
सो इट्स बेसिकली द क्वालिटीज ऑफ यू विच इफ यू वांट टू प्ले अ गिटार इफ यू हैव अ मेंटल वेल यू कैन प्ले द गिटार वेरी वेल.
वेल इन केस द होम्योपैथी थिंग डजंट वर्क आउट फॉर डॉक्टर रहुजा, he can surely fall back on motivational speaking as a career. Well, one thing's for certain, Dr. Rahuja, like most homeopathic doctors, doesn't seem to be lying. He really does believe that homeopathy helps his patients. The problem, however, is that nice and well-meaning people can also be completely and utterly wrong about everything.
As we said in the report, it's entirely possible that homeopathic doctors believe that they are administering things that will help their patients. But it's a fact that homeopathy flies in the name of science. What's even more worrying is, like what you saw in the report, the government of India hasn't just failed to clamp down against bogus forms of medicine, it in fact is actively promoting it. The Ayush Ministry, which is responsible for research, development and propagation of healthcare in the country, has homeopathy in its name. Yes. Ayush stands for Ayurveda, Yoga, Yunani, Siddha, and you guessed it, homeopathy. That's like creating a ministry for environmental welfare and calling it SMOG, short form for smoke, mist, oil, and garbage. So let me ask you this. In a country like India, where farmers are facing massive financial crisis, where several cities and towns desperately require investment into infrastructure, where even regular medicine, healthcare, and a healthy diet is still not accessible to millions of our fellow citizens, how can we afford to throw crores into labs that do nothing but manufacture a glorified form of water? How is that nobody is questioning this? The government immediately needs to stop funding homeopathy. Even after all this, I'm sure some of you still aren't convinced that homeopathy is bogus. So just to put your doubts to rest, I'll be taking this. This is a full bottle of homeopathic sleeping pills. Cheers. There you go. This amount of sleeping pills should even put... There's a lot of sugar. There you go. This amount of sleeping pills should be enough to put a horse to sleep. But yet, here I am sitting before you completely unharmed. Oh, wait a minute. I actually feel... Oh, no, I'm fine. No, I'm completely fine. I'm completely fine, guys. I'm completely fine. It was just Chris Hemsworth's piss. Thank you, guys. Thank you for watching. That's the show. Thank you for watching.